Welcome. My name is Stacy Lewis, and I work within the Office of the Chief Data Officer at the Texas Department of Information Resources. Today, I'm going to walk you through the Data Management and Analytics Maturity Assessment. And we're going to look at four stages: Access, Input, Submission, and Output. Before we look at the assessment, I'd like to talk about the section of the Texas Government Code where this requirement is outlined. Senate Bill 475 added Section 2054.137 to the code, which directs every state agency and institution of higher education with more than 150 full-time employees to designate a data management officer, a DMO. Among other activities, the DMO is responsible for conducting a data maturity assessment of the agency's governance program. A few important things to note. It is not prescribed that any particular assessment must be used, including the one I am talking about in this video. An agency or IHE may use a data maturity assessment of their own choosing. Additionally, there is no set due date, but best practice is to complete the assessment once per year to benchmark and monitor the growth and opportunities of your agency's data management program. The assessment housed in the SPECTRIM system will be available to complete once per calendar year. So now let's get into those stages of the assessment. We'll first talk about access. You'll use this URL to log into the SPECTRIM system. It is recommended to use Chrome or Edge. The username is your agency email address. And if you forget your password, you can reset it using the self-service reset function. If your account has become inactive, or if you're having issues logging in, email grc@dir.texas.gov. Once you are logged in, if you're not already on the data management workspace, select it from the header bar. Click on Questionnaire ID to open the assessment. Again, this will be available to complete once per calendar year. The assessment is divided into sections: Instructions, which also contains a glossary, General Information, Submission, the 11 subject areas containing the questions, and Comments. In discussing access, it's important to note the delegate function contained within the general information section. Please note this is optional. The DMO is the default owner of the assessment submission process. However, there may be the need for collaboration to complete the assessment. You can add delegates and they will receive notification to log in and update responses. If the individual is not listed in the dialog box, they will need an account. You can create a support ticket or email grc@dir.texas.gov to get them added. Of importance to note, only one user will be able to edit the assessment at a time. So now that we have access, let's talk about the input process. A few tips to make data entry easy. Do not use the browser back button. You'll also want to save often. The portal does not have an auto-save functionality. And again, only one user will be able to edit a record at a time. As you answer and save, the progress measurement in the submission section will change. As mentioned, there are 11 subject sections. Each subject has an abbreviation, such as you see here, DGS for Data Governance and Standardization. These abbreviations are also listed in the glossary in the instructions section at the beginning of the assessment. Question responses are in two formats, choosing from yes, in process, or no, or choosing a level from 1 to 5. All level choices do provide a description. The assessment is designed so that you will respond to a particular question as to where your agency currently is now. And then you'll identify your agency's goal in the following question: where do you want to be next year? You can click on the sticky note on the right of any question to make notes about the questions or your response. All notes will be listed in the comments section at the end of the assessment for your agency's reference. Next, let's look at submission. The assessment cannot be submitted until it is 100% complete. Once you have responded to all questions, locate the submission section, it's the third from the top, and click Check Assessment Progress. This will save and update the progress measure. Additionally, once at 100%, the submission status field can now be edited. Agencies may elect to assign a reviewer. Like the delegate function, this is optional. Once the assessment is submitted, it would then go to the reviewer, who would change the review status to approved to officially complete the submission process. Because I'm not adding a reviewer here, I'm just changing the submission status to submitted, and then I'm going to save and close. Once submitted, you can no longer edit the assessment. If changes are needed, you can contact the Office of the Chief Data Officer for assistance, and our contact information is provided at the end of this video. After submission, the DMO will receive an email confirming assessment completion and include a link to the assessment. Fourth and finally, let's discuss the assessment output. The progress measure on the data management workspace will now show as 100% complete. After opening the assessment, there are several options to choose. You may print a copy of the assessment by going to the ellipse menu, the three dots here to the right. You can also use the export function to export your responses to a variety of file formats. Let's take a moment to see that in action. This is an example of one of the output options. I chose to export my assessment as a PDF. This also gives a good view of what the assessment looks like after it's been submitted. The first section you see are the instructions, which include the glossary for those different sections that were completed within the assessment. Next, we're going to come to general information and submission. As a reminder, the delegate and reviewer functions are optional. If I had chosen anyone to be a delegate or a reviewer, they would have appeared here. The next section we're going to come to is the scoring summary. The scoring summary provides the averages for the overall assessment as well as the different sections within the assessment. You'll see on the left-hand side the averages for what was reported as current for the agency or the institution of higher education. Then looking to the right, you'll see the target or the goal responses. Scrolling through the scoring summary, you'll find the different sections containing the questions and the responses. Once you reach the end of the questions and responses, you'll come to the comments section. If you did add any information using the sticky note icons for any question, that information will appear here. To recap, we have looked at the four stages of the data maturity assessment process: access, input, submission, and output. If you do have any questions, please don't hesitate to contact us at the Office of the Chief Data Officer, and our email address is ocdo@dir.texas.gov. For any issues with the SPECTRIM portal, please email grc@dir.texas.gov. We hope this video has been helpful, and thank you for your time.